Moving on from that, the new direct tax code draft will not completely override bilateral tax treaties, but the government will use the new anti-avoidance rules to plug loopholes. This will also trigger the review of bilateral treaties that India has with countries suspected of being tax havens. Sapna Das brings us the details.
The Finance Ministry is sending a clear message to companies and individuals keen to do business with India. And that is, watch out if you're evading taxes under the bilateral tax treaties. Very soon, the Indian government will be armed with the new anti-avoidance regulation under the new direct tax code. And NDTV learns the framing of the general anti-avoidance rule or GAR will also force a review of select bilateral tax treaties. In fact, specific treaties might even be covered under the general anti-avoidance rules, the Indo-Mauritius Treaty being on top of the list. As a result, companies and individuals registered in Mauritius will not be able to avail tax exemptions in India simply on the grounds of being a foreign resident. This is especially true if the CBDT or the Central Board of Direct Taxes decides to use the anti-avoidance rule to probe a particular deal or transaction.
Maybe an issue only in terms of which are the companies, by merely incorporating a company in Mauritius, may not be considered to be the resident eligible for taking the tax benefit under the treaty. So maybe they may like to come out to see that the companies which are operating from Mauritius, how much substance is there in those companies, and that's something which may be subject to the review.
However, some relief for the markets, as under the treaty review, the Finance Ministry is not going to touch the Mauritius registered FIIs. The government is clear that over 90% of these institutional investors are already paying capital gains tax. In New Delhi, Sapna Das, NDTV.